there, welcome! Let's see how to create effects and transitions with Adobe After Effects CC. Please leave feedbacks if you find mistakes in our English. Let's pick a general layer. When you click on a small arrow next to the layer name, you will have a list with all the basic settings for your layer. If it's a picture, you will have just the transform section. If it's sound, you will have audio section. If you have a video, you will have both. Use audio section to set the volume of the layer. You can click and drag the value, or you can click on it and type it. Remember to press 0 from your number pad to hear audio in the preview. Invisible layers, transform is used to apply basic settings such as scaling, rotation, position and opacity level. Click on reset to come back to the layer as it was originally. These are the basic effects you can add to your layer. After Effects has plenty of effects you can further add. Go to Windows section and then to Effects and Presets. This lists all the effects you have installed, the ones included in your software and the ones from external plugins. We won't see all of them, but let's see, basically, how to apply any effect you can find here onto your layer. First of all, on top, you have the search bar. If you remember the name of the effect you are looking for, you can waste no time in searching it in the list. There are three main kinds of effects you have here. The presets, that are ready-made collections of effects put together to give a proper aspect to your layer. The audio effects, indicated through a loudspeaker icon, that are effective on layers with sound. And the visible effects, that change the aspect of the layer, for images, videos or text. These are represented through brick icons and a number inside which is the color depth. In short, a higher color depth is better able to save the color spread of the original photo. This may be important in professional projects. To add one of these effects, simply select it and drag it on the interested layer. This can be found in a new section created called Effects, that will list also all the future effects you are going to add. Each one will have its different properties and settings. Use the reset option next to the effect names to come back to the default values, and the FX icon used to hide or apply again each of these extra effects added. If you want to delete an effect, simply select it and then press Ctrl and X using your keyboard. To adjust the settings of each layer, you can also use the Effect Controls panel next to Project. Select first the layer interested and then manage all effects. Mind that the more effects you will apply to your layer, the more load and memory After Effects may require from your computer. Lower the quality in case you start waiting a long time for a rendered preview. You can put effects that do change in time, which means having effects whose properties chosen change in time. To do this, you need to know how to use the keyframes. Activate the keyframes clicking on the stopwatch icon next to the property you want to change in time. The keyframes are points that fix, in an instant of time, a precise value for the chosen property, so that if you have two keyframes following, but with different values for the property, The effect will change between the first and the second keyframe in a linear manner, and between the instant where the first keyframe is placed and the second ones. A keyframe is added every time you change the property in an instant of time, where the playhead is set in the timeline. It can be managed very easily. Click on it to select it. Selected keyframes are in yellow color. Drag it to move it. Press Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C, and Ctrl and V to cut, copy, or paste the selected keyframe. If you want to come back editing the property value related to a keyframe, make sure to have the playhead set on such keyframe, or you will add a new one. In some effects, you may find a number plus an X. This indicates the cycles you are applying to the effect. Some of these, for example the rotation one, are periodic, when 360 degrees gives the same effect of 0 degrees. In a static effect, they are the same. But if you do this with keyframes, you will end up with a full cycle, with the object that rotates one time fully. Remember it. To come back to the static effect property, simply click again on the stopwatch icon. Mind that you will lose all the keyframes previously done. In the effects and presets list, there are different kinds of visible effects. Most of them change the aspect of the layer according to what an effect does. Some others are presets that you can find inside animation presets. Adding one of them means adding a collection of effects according to the kind of presets. Then there are the generators, so the effects that do transform totally the layer to create particles, geometrical shapes or backgrounds. They are mostly used on vacant layers. All these can be found under Text and Generate sections. There are other effects known as transitions. A transition is an effect that makes a layer appear and disappear. These are inside the transition section. As long as you have them added into a layer, they are completely static. You can use the timeline or the effect controls to adjust the settings of the transition effect. But still, you won't obtain a transition at all. To make it up, you need to create keyframes applied on the completion percentage. To make the layer appear, you need to set a keyframe to 100% and the one following at 0%. To make it disappear later, you need other two keyframes, the first one at 0% and the second one at 100% of completion value. Different transitions set a different way to make the layer appear and disappear, but they all work the same in this way. Set a couple of keyframes where you want to build up a transition. This is all. Thanks for watching this video. Check our full guide for Adobe After Effects CC if you want to learn more.